The Edelweiss staff will doubtless be eager to show off their facility to a fellow physician. I have already taken the liberty of sending a letter on your behalf to request a visit.
And what of you?
I shall be pursuing other avenues. Should you see anything troublesome or improper, simply notify the local authorities. Otherwise, try a little analysis yourself. You know my methods. Apply them.
Salutations, madam. I am Dr. John Watson. I was wondering if you've got word of my visit.
Yeah, Dr. Watson. We received your letter on the matter. Would it be to see Professor Gygax?
The asylum's facilities, actually. I've heard great things about the work you do here.
Permission to go anywhere would have to come from Professor Gygax. Wait here, bitte. Mr. and Mrs. Bronson, your girl has made remarkable progress. See? Take a look for yourself.
My apologies for keeping you waiting, Dr. Watson. Surely you understand how medical work can make one lose track of time.
Do not be sorry, Professor. I too know the importance of closely attending to patients.
The work hardly stops here, yet the satisfaction of perfecting the mind compels us to persevere.
I take it you welcome many a soul into your establishment?
Admissions, yes. Visitors, though? I am curious as to what brought you to the Schwarzes Edelweiss.
Word of mouth. An article I read back in London spoke highly of your institution. But rather than taking its word for it, I thought I would see things for myself.
My asylum's reputation precedes it, then.
Everyone, your attention, please. Guten Day. Yes, hi. Hello. The name's Amos Colby, Northwood Detective Agency, Boston. I got questions that need answers. Who's in charge here?
What seems to be the matter, Dr. Watson? You can tell me.
By Jove, it cannot be him. Right. Yes! I was surprised because that man is a celebrity. Yes, that's it. Very famous, Mr. Colby. I couldn't believe my eyes.
No, 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 no. In my line of work, it can't wait. The longer it takes
if you
to
wish
get to
recuperate,
truth,
Dr. Watson, you may avail yourself of the guest room.
But I have so much more to discuss.
Nurse, if you'd be so kind as to escort Dr. Watson to the guest room. Herr Colby, from Northwood Agency. How unexpected. I am Professor Gygax. I would be happy to answer your questions in the examination room.
Look, Professor, unless you got any clues as to the whereabouts of...
There is no need to be alarmed. No one gets neglected in my care.
Now, let's not resort to brute force.
Do not worry, Herr Colby. My methods are rather more delicate. Search him thoroughly. Then take him to the holding chamber. Need to decide precisely what to do with our guest.
Unmistakable scent of alcoholism. Did you walk through their doors as I did, or did they collect you off the streets?
Truncheon, not the typical tool for a nurse.
there? I command you to free me at once.
I'm not sure that's a great idea at the moment.
How dare you deny me? I must have my revenge against the Lickspittles upstairs.
Fortunately for you, I'm here to stop the very same people.
You are?
Indeed. But first, I must discover all I can about this institution. Tell me, have you witnessed the arrival of any foreign patients?
Tell me? T'Gol? The impertinence to bark such orders?
Please, we don't have time for this.
Do you know with whom you speak? I am the great Napoleon.
Napoleon Bonaparte?
The one and only. Emperor of the French, first consul of the Republic, leader of La Grande Armée. Once I am free and have exacted my revenge against the guards who ridicule me, I shall rest happy in the arms of my beloved Josephine.
Right. Well, I will leave you to your scheming, Emperor.
My heart is pierced by Cupid. I disdain all glittering gold. There is nothing can console me but my jolly sailor bold.
Any chemist would envy the quality of this equipment. The final product, ready to cure madness, or to push one deeper into its grasp. Materials used to formulate medicine. With this equipment, they can create any type of medication. Very sturdy. I might borrow it.
What was that? Is someone there? I'm sure I heard something.
A certificate of appreciation from the municipal councillor to Professor Becker for contributions to the development of medicine in Interlaken. A simple toolbox, yet capable of repairing anything. Tubes of varying diameters. Interesting. Speech and the Cerebellum by S.A. Becker. John Sallow, the Tulpa phenomenon. I'm somewhat of an expert already. R.G. Hill, Dr. Connolly. It appears that all the psychiatric classics were banished here. This photo was damaged, seemingly by oil. I can make out the names listed here. Cooking grease. Is this the kitchen dumbwaiter? Looks like it's still operational. painting in a mental institution. Vogel would be delighted. John Sallow, the Tulpa phenomenon. I'm somewhat of an expert already.
I command you to let me out!
This sedative worked faster than I expected. Perhaps I ought to train myself, build up a tolerance. Thank you. I'd rather not sit in this chair ever again. Locked. I suppose the reception will be guarded anyway. There's the guest room. I wonder if Watson was able to speak to Gygax. Darn. No way I can get past him without being noticed. This should suffice. This should be enough to avoid unwanted attention, at least from a distance. This is the same narcotic substance that we found in London. Manufactured and packaged here.
will tear your lips from your skull with my fingernails!
Miss, I...
I'll gouge your eyes out and cut off your hands, just like you did to Heidi.
I am quite certain you would, but I'm afraid you have me mistaken for someone else. So, I take it your name is Gerda. Who is Heidi?
You talk strange. You're going to Hell's Door, aren't you? To where those other funny talkers finally shut up?
Hell's Door? To what do you refer?
Only Heidi had answers. Go away, pig!
I merely...
I said go, or you will spend your last moments on Earth screaming. This door won't stop me. They took you away, and I'll never forgive them. Why did they hurt you, Heidi?
I wish I could hear your voice again.
Fabric burnt in the furnace. A jalabia, a traditional garment from Northern Africa. The garments of several dozen people at least. So you're Heidi. I didn't realize I was on Haunted Doll Watch. Good Lord, how unsettling. The damage seems intentional.
So this is how they kept the prisoners docile and harmless. Orthodox reliquary commonly found in Eastern Europe, now in a cell halfway up the Alps.
Make them pay for what they did to Heidi.
I believe I have found your friend.
Heidi! Oh, poor girl. What did they do to you?
Shh. It's all right now. Everything will be all right.
Please, Gerda, now I have found Heidi, I need some help from you in return.
Shh, Heidi. You should thank the man, don't you think?
Tell me all you know about those funny-talking people.
We'd hear their screams. The guards would take them down the corridor behind you, and they'd disappear. And the screams would stop.
How did you end up in Block B?
The nurses say I'm prone to violent outbursts. But they're wrong. I just do what Heidi tells me.
Professor Gygax seems to rule this facility with an iron fist. Do you know anything about her?
She's sick. She did nasty things to us. Separated me and Heidi just for fun. Before she got here, this place was all right.
Have you ever met Professor Becker?
I remember him. He was in charge here before that witch Gygax. But I haven't heard his voice for a long time. Too bad. He was nice.
I shall leave you two to get reacquainted. This stretcher was disinfected frequently. These are the same crates we found in London. I should take a closer look. Dirt and sweat. They were locked in here for days, judging by the smell. This is the same design as the one from London. I doubt that one could survive such a journey with this little water. The kidnappers even provided airflow. How generous. This trip was prolonged and perilous. A bottle this sturdy doesn't break by accident. Substantial blood loss. One poor soul found another way out. The stamp on this crate confirms it came from America. That's quite a distance to travel. The doors can be opened for deliveries. Thank you. were back through these doors, and they began to unload their cargo in secret. Next, the crates were opened, freeing their passengers. Not everyone survived the journey. The dirty, exhausted, and dehydrated prisoners were then herded into cells. But all the cells are now empty, and I have not located a morgue. Time to find Hell's Door. Doors can be opened for deliveries. Scratches. Something has been moved through here. This seems to be a locking mechanism. The whole thing must be a door.
Make them pay for what they did to Heidi.
I found Hell's Door, the one that made the foreigners silent, remember? How do I open it? Gerda, please. I cannot get inside. You have to tell me how to open it.
How can you speak to me like nothing's wrong? Can't you hear Heidi crying? Look at her! Look! She's suffering. I can't even hear my thoughts over her screams. Poor, poor Heidi. We will fix you. I promise. We will fix you!
Leave it with me, Gerda.
You're going to be good as new. Stay with me, Heidi. I can't lose you again.
My comrades in Paris shall hear about this! Don't you look down on me. Open the door. They haven't yet made a bullet that can hit me.
Thank you.
Will this help fix your friend?
Give it to me.
How is she feeling?
Everything will be all right, Heidi. Everything.
Goethe, I have a couple of questions.
Yes, I...
Dirty little mouth, Goethe. You've said enough already. She won't speak no more. Now it's only Heidi. You helped me, and I didn't cut out your eyes. So we're even. Now go!
Heidi, there are things I need some clarity on.
Ask if you dare, but if I get bored, there will be consequences!
I found Hell's Door, but it's locked. Is there a way to get in?
Hell's Door? Never heard of it.
That's not true. You, Goethe, told me that Hell's Door makes people silent forever.
And you believe that snotty little girl? I'll personally ensure that she
never dares to speak again!
Professor Gygax hurt you repeatedly, scarred your body and mind. You are not protecting Hell's Door. You are simply afraid of the consequences were I to enter.
I could tap your teeth out with a hammer until you choked on the blood in bits.
You could. But then you would live the rest of your life in fear of Professor Gygax. I can make that feeling go away.
How?
I can stop her. But the key, Heidi, the key to Hell's Door is critical to stopping Professor Gygax. And I think you know where it is.
Tell him!
But you said...
And now I say tell him!
The professor, she has a special key. Keeps it close and only brings it down when new people go through. Behind those closed doors, those people start to sing. Well, they sing in so much pain.
Gygax, of course. Thank you, Goethe. Heidi, I must leave.
Leave? You joke. Nobody leaves the Edelweiss. Now you will be with us forever!